UK travel COVID restrictions have gone. That's pretty fucking cool. And if you are, like me, someone who never complied with any of this bullshit, you're fucking amazing and I love you. Because it looks like we made it through, at least the COVID bullshit, yeah? No more vaccine passports, no lockdown in sight, no vaccine mandates, and now you can leave the country and come back without any COVID bullshit. That's really fucking awesome. And I imagine the list of countries that are doing away with the rest of the restrictions will continue to grow. So that's cool. There's at least like 10 to 11 that also have the same route as England right now, or the UK. Ireland being one of them. And it's like, oh my God, I can actually get on a plane, go to fucking Ireland and come back and not have to worry about all of this COVID bullshit, and I'm not fucking vaccinated. How amazing is that? So then it's like, well, okay, where do we go next? And I have many videos talking about, you know, the next steps in the activist world for people living in the UK. For sure, we haven't exactly won yet, and our enemies are still out there and they're still scheming on how can we control humanity. So there'll be more things to focus on. But I won't talk about too much in this video. In this video, I just want to share a little bit about what I've been thinking about, a little bit more metaphysically, a little bit more spiritually, because that is the direction I want to keep getting this, taking this page, taking this movement, taking Open One, and taking my life, really. Because I think it's one of the most powerful things anybody can do is work on themselves, personally develop and develop a spiritual belief system, a spiritual practice, a spiritual way of being. And I do theorize that there's sort of this whole thing of collective reality creation, and people some pull together to bring in and pull away different experiences and different things happening to the nation. And it's kind of mysterious how that would play out on the physical actual realm, but I do believe that sort of exists. And then that ties into what I've been looking into a lot recently, is David Hawkins' work, which ties into Rupert Sheldrake's work, which you've got David Hawkins' map or scale of consciousness, and then you've got Rupert Sheldrake, who didn't exactly come up with the idea of morphogenetic fields, but he's been pioneering the whole idea of that, how we are all connected by sort of unseen energy connections, and how when what happens in one happens to all. So that's why, actually, in part, the slogan for Open One is Open One, Open All. If one person is awakened, if one person evolves and grows and develops, it opens everyone. It grows and evolves everybody. And that's really, really empowering if you're someone who's like, wants to help people. If you clear and do away with your own darkness, your own shit, your trauma, your wounds, and become more of a light being and being able to embody more of the powerful, higher energetic frequencies, then you literally lift up the entire race. You lift up all of humanity. And that's really cool. And it's not even just the people that you come into contact with. Like, obviously, that's where you can have the biggest impact. But I also theorize that it goes beyond that. It goes literally all of the unseen, hidden connections that are happening, like, all of the time. And then I think that's partly why our enemies are so desperate to keep the fear going. Because if humanity gets too awakened, gets too high-vibed, maybe it just becomes, pull in like a really amazing timeline, who knows? It's interesting to think about. I like to ponder these higher concepts and sort of, you know, how we can integrate it into our daily lives, and then what we can actions we can actually take, because I find it's very, very empowering. And anyone who wants to be, anyone who's an activist, right, they want to see and be the change in the world. They want to create a better world. But then a great perspective to have is how, if you can personally develop, if you can spiritually evolve, that helps our activist cause. That helps our fighting the bad guys cause. That helps the good guys. That helps divinity. That helps God. That helps a more beautiful, harmonious timeline be manifested. So I find that's really, really empowering. I like to think about that. I like to ponder that. And I like to think about, yeah, if I'm clearing and working on my stuff, it helps me create a better life, helps me have a better impact on all the people around me, all the people I talk to, all the people that I meet, the videos I create, the content I create. All of that is touched with a higher vibe, a more harmonious vibe, if you like, and that raises everybody. So I think that's really, really cool. So in other videos on my website, on the page, you'll find me talking about what activists in the UK need to focus on the nuts and bolts, ground level, what we need to sort out, because we haven't won yet. But then I like to talk about these higher concepts, because I think there's great benefit in pondering these things, because that's how we evolve, that's how we grow, that's how we develop, and that is how we truly, truly win. Because it's all well and good waking up, but if you then wake up and then you don't do anything, well, I think you're kind of missing something. But if you wake up and then you evolve, but that's when really the magic happens. So I just thought I'd talk to you guys about this, about what's going on in my mind, and stay tuned on the page if you are new or if you haven't seen my sort of content before. This is sort of the direction we're going to go in general, more positive, empowering spiritual stuff, as well as still keeping our eye on the ball on what our enemies are trying to do. But yeah, if you're living in the UK right now and you're unvaccinated, and you never wore a mask, you never had one of these tests, fucking big ups to you. You're amazing. And you are part of the reason, I believe, why the UK now has no COVID restrictions, because millions of us never complied. We said no right from the fucking start, and then more of us came and joined us along the way. And I believe that's why COVID doesn't exist in England right now. So big ups to you guys. You're beautiful. I love you. And let's keep going. Keep this momentum going, because we haven't won yet.